VC, what's up? I'm back at you. Let me drop this. Back at you on Tuesday because of I got some records to show. You know, the way I do things in real time, real life, and my order for record mailers came in, so I have to travel out to the west part of Omaha to do that, to get them. It's a local business that makes them, which is nice, you know, support the local economy. But I don't go out west Omaha too much, so while I was out there, I decided to go ahead and check in at Half Price Books because it's pretty far away from my house, so I don't go there. And I must invoke the name of Chris Cole, John Coltrane 68, because he is the king of Half Price Book finds. And I had him in mind when I went out there because the Half Price Books here is nothing compared to what he is able to dig up in Chicago. But I thought to myself, come on now, I can find something today. When I got out there, the initial digging was really sad. It was the same shit, you know. But I kept digging, and in the jazz, the first thing that I came across was this that was decent that I didn't have for. And I wanted to get things at a decent price. I wanted to find some $3 finds, you know, like Chris, dollar, $3, $4. I think the most I paid for something today was $6, but this, $3, $2.99. I've had this on CD forever, and this is a great, as you can hear, it's a great Wayne Shorter album. Really nice, fresh sound, you know, just Atlantis. 1985 on CBS. Larry Klein, Alejandro Acuna, Michael Honig, and Ralph Humphrey. Cool. It's been a while since I've looked at this, but this was one of my finds. I found a couple things. Nothing earth-shattering that I remember. This is the only thing I've played, and I haven't even looked through the records. I just got home and said, heck, let me make a video. Just made an afternoon pot of coffee. Feeling pretty good in general. And so let me show you what else I found. I found the Wayne Shorter. I went ahead and bought this. It has people on it that usually would keep me from buying it, but I'm growing. This is a Kazumi Watanabe album on Inner City. Mermaid Boulevard. Now, I gotta tell you, the names that put me off, Lee Ritenour and Patrice Rushen and Ernie Watts. I mean, those are good players, but see, that particular flavor is not what I'm looking for. They're good players, you know. But one thing I have decided in recent times is when I can pick up Inner City, and when I can pick up anything on the Inner City label that I don't have for cheap, I'm doing it. And this is $2.99. I haven't played this yet, but I have several other Kazumi Watanabe albums. And generally, for my taste, this stuff is a little too coffee table, but we'll see. We'll see, okay? I picked up some classical. I do listen to classical, but I also like the Deutsche Grammophon visual aesthetic. This is still sealed. This is some Brahms. Four Ballads, Opus 10. Seven Fantasies, Opus 10. Emil Gilels. Now, on this man, I have some other stuff by him on piano. What a touch. Again, that's one thing about wonderful musicians. In the hands of a particular interpreter, a piece of music means something, like Emil Gilels, Maurizio Pollini, Martha Argerich, you know, those are some people, you know. Sviatoslav Richter, you know what I'm saying? They'll take a piece of music and it'll be the same thing and it'll be a whole nother world because of the way that they approach it. So, $2.99 still sealed? Come on. David Lanz on Narada, Nightfall. This is going to be some nice... I have some David Lanz, and this ain't cheesy. This is some wonderful atmospheric music. Nightfall, piano solos. I picked this up, it's more Bach. Really nice German pressing. Italian solo... Italian solo cantatas on Telemusic. Again, these records for $2.99, and then again, I will be listening to this stuff. It's not just going to be sitting. Really nice pressings, as I've said recently. I love the way records are pressed in Europe, in particular. And so I love. Oh man, this is like no one ever played this. Maybe it got played once or twice by the radio station. That this is the radio station copy. Bach is can be like taking vitamins musically. Bach is good for the constitution. Excuse me. This Wayne Shorter is lovely in the background. I've always loved this album. So this was the first Tomita album that I had ever gotten. So consequently, my copy is pretty tore up. So to get a nice, clean copy on Red Seal of Tomita's Snowflakes Are Dancing for $2.99, $3 today, that's a nice score. And this is still one of my favorites by him because he's doing Debussy. I love Debussy. Speaking of Debussy, I have to tape this cover, but here we have Claudio Abbado conducting. Three Nocturnes, Nuages, Fête Sirenes, and then the... It's interesting how they always, not quite often, these two, Debussy and Ravel, it's like a program that is, I have several different orchestras and conductors doing this program. They go together well, they do. I picked this up for, what was this? This was $3.99. The record's in fair shape, but it's the die-cut cover. I had to get it. Rolling Stones, Through the Dark, Through the Past Darkly, Big Hits Volume 2. That's in pretty decent shape, cover-wise, for $3.99. And the record is okay. The record's okay. Which is, it's not a big deal. It's cool. This is cool for my Stones collection. I do have a Stones collection. And awesome, you know, it's got the original inner sleeve for it and everything. For basically for $4, I said this is a buy. Looking forward to playing this. African Sanctus, including the Lord's Prayer. David Fanshawe. This looks interesting. This looks interesting. Yeah, we'll see. African recordings from Egypt, Sudan, Uganda, and Kenya by David Fanshawe. This looks very interesting on Philips. It's only $4. I said, oh shit, this doesn't that look... Doesn't that look fantastic? Needs a glue job, I see here. It's got a... Look at this. This feels to me like a find. This record, like I said, I have not played it yet. But it feels like this is going to be something cool. Something I learned from. African Sanctus. Italian pressing on Philips. Love it. And these pictures, this cover, you know, still, it's quite, this is quite an arresting image. So I'm really looking forward to finding out what this is about. Bizet Karajan, Herbert von Karajan, doing the L'Arlesian Suites, numbers 1 and 2, Carmen Suite, with the Berlin Philharmonic. Again on Deutsche. And I can't leave these in the store, you know. I think this is the one I paid the most for. I have two more to show. This I paid the most for this. $5.99 I paid for this. This was a nice find. Hugh Masekela on Uni. In great condition. Bit of ring wear on the cover. But look, you know, how dark that cover is. And considering how old this album is, this is in great shape. And then the album, fantastic. Needs to be cleaned up, but it's absolutely clean. Another one on that fantastic Uni label. Yeah. This was probably the find of the day that I know of. That other African album I'm thinking is a good one. And the last one was a great find as well. So these are the two I paid the most for. Masekela was $5.99, and this Egberto Gismonti Group, I paid $5.99 for this. With Jacques Morlenbaum, Nando Carneiro, wow. Zeko Assumpção, Infancia, on ECM. You know I'm always happy to pick up some more ECM for my collection. So today was feels like today was a good day as far as oh fuck yes, pardon me, this is a German ECM pressing, hell yes. I didn't even peep that in the store. You know, I was kind of handling it and sort of feeling that it was a nice, good, solid, yep, printed in Germany. Awesome. Okay. I just really wanted to share the booty with you. And, yeah, I'm going to actually have a talk to the manager of the one store regarding the way that employee, just the way that they looked at me. I mean, they got it together when they spoke to me somewhat, but that look, I'm sorry, I've been working with people too long and too intensely. I'm pretty damn good at reading body language, and I got dissed. Like, huh, you coming here with a record, pick you somebody? That's exactly what the response was to my fucking face. Even if I was just a dingbat with a box of junk, I don't deserve that. You know, I try a little harder myself, and I guess that's what I gauge it by. It's like, come on now, come on. All right. That's enough for now. I'll talk to you.